What is Hamburger's phenomenon? When bicarbonate ions diffuse out into plasma from RBC, to replace them, chloride ions will enter into RBC at tissue level. That means during internal respiration. This is called chloride shift, which is also called Hamburger's phenomenon. At the level of alveoli, chloride ion again moves out into the plasma and bicarbonate ion move in. This is called reverse of chloride shift. When we come to regulation of respiration, breathing generally occurs involuntarily. It is not under our control. Generally, normal adult human being breathe 12 to 16 times per minute, and an infant will breathe 44 times per minute. And humans have ability to regulate breathing rate. Regulation of respiration is both nervous and chemical. Nervous regulation, when we discuss about nervous regulation, there are two centers in the brain for regulation of respiration: respiratory rhythm center and pneumotoxic center. It is specialized center. Respiratory rhythm center is specialized center which is located in medullary region of hindbrain. It can either cause expiration or inspiration according to the needs, when the neurons are activated, and they regulate respiratory rhythm center according to the needs of the body. And coming to pneumotoxic center, which is located in pons region of the hindbrain, it moderates the function of respiratory rhythm center. So those two are the neural, they come under neural regulation. When we discuss about chemical regulation, chemosensitive area, which is sensitive for chemicals, is present just adjacent to the rhythm center, respiratory rhythm center. Chemoreceptors are present in the chemosensitive areas, which are sensitive to carbon dioxide and H+ ions. So rhythm center will be stimulated by this chemoreceptors present in the chemosensitive area. Concentration of partial pressure of CO2 and H+ ions will stimulate the rhythm center. pH, which is present in blood and body fluids, those are H+ ion concentration. Chemosensitive area gets activated due to an increase in CO2 and H+ ions, which in turn activate the respiratory rhythm center for altering the rate of respiration. For example, an increase in CO2 in blood increases the rate and depth of respiration, and decrease in CO2 will depress the rate and depth of respiration. So CO2 and H+ ions are their sensitive receptors are present for these ions in chemoreceptors. They are present, they are located on aortic arch. They are called aortic bodies, these chemosensory areas. And when they are located in carotid arteries, the chemosensitive areas or receptors present in carotid arteries are carotid bodies. Carotid arteries are the arteries which supply blood to the brain. Increase in concentration of CO2 in blood lowers the pH value, and decrease in CO2 concentration in blood raises the pH value. The low pH of blood increases the rate of respiration. That means whenever CO2 concentration becomes more, it increases the rate of respiration. Here, very very important thing for NEET or for JIPMER or AIMS, O2 has no role to play in regulating the rate of respiration. It has no role. Okay. So that is about the regulation of the rate of the respiration. And now about disorders of respiration. Asthma is major disorder due to allergens. It will be caused. It is affecting the upper respiratory tract. The symptoms are spasm of smooth muscles in the valve of the bronchiole. Will be caused coughing, wheezing, difficulty in breathing. And inflammation means swelling and redness of the bronchi and bronchioles occur in asthma. And emphysema is another major disorder which is caused due to cigarette smoking and inhalation of smoke. The smokers, when we stand behind beside the smokers, the smoke also will cause the emphysema. The symptoms are the wall of the alveoli gets damaged due to excessive smoking, loss of elasticity. The walls of bronchioles and alveoli will lose their character of elasticity, and the surface area for exchange of gases will be reduced. So even after expiration, the cavity will be full of air. The lungs are inflated. Exhalation becomes difficult. By avoiding cigarette smoking, we can prevent the emphysema. Coming to the occupational respiratory disorders, continuous exposure to harmful substances, gases, fumes and dust in environment where a person works, the disorders will be seen, like silicosis and asbestosis. Continuous exposure to silica, silicosis will be caused. Continuous exposure to asbestos dust, asbestosis will be caused. Symptoms will be serious damage to lungs due to fibrosis of upper part of lungs, proliferation of this fibrous tissue causing inflammation, that is swelling and redness of lungs. So better to avoid prolonged exposure to such dusts with pollutants, and workers should wear protective masks while working in industries. So with this, we completed respiratory system of human beings.